Requirements. Why do I call requirements written down lessons learned? And why should we think about them that way? AC-67 is a great example. This is when, you remember back in the Challenger time, we lost one of everything. And one of the spacecraft, or space launch vehicles that went down was an Atlas II, and it had a fleet SATCOM, very expensive satellite on top, and it was struck by lightning. Now I bring this one up because I was the guy that wrote the endorsement letter for Dick Truly on this one. He gave me the accident report. I was not in the investigation, so I can't claim that kind of detailed knowledge. All I did was sit and read the investigation and the transcripts of the people in the Mission Control Center, or the Launch Control Center. And then I drafted a draft endorsement for Truly, and he signed it out. So I'm pretty familiar with this one. What was good was that, well, let me establish the case here. We have no window. We can launch this anytime, and we've got bad weather. And there's two or three weather LCCs that are in play here. There's been a little lightning here and there. There's a lot of rain in the area, clouds. So it's kind of a grim day. Now, there are periods of time when all they have is clouds. And there's a launch commit criterion that's hanging them up. And you can read through the transcript as the meteorology officer talks to the launch director. Okay, the problem we have is we got this launch commit criterion for clouds no thicker, or no clouds that are 6,000 feet thick or thicker over the launch path with the freezing level in the clouds. And we've got that case. Freezing levels in the clouds, 6,000 feet, can't go. So the two of them decide, well, that one's hanging us up. Everything else is okay. Let's call a pilot. Brewster Shaw had just landed a T-38 out at the SLF. And they called out to ops, Brewster, did you get any ice on your wings when you came down? No, no ice. Okay, call a T-39 pilot. Out at Patrick. They talked to the pilot out there. Did you get any ice on your wings when you came through those clouds? No, I got no ice. Okay, well, there's no ice, so maybe it'd be okay. And they talked themselves into going ahead and launching. And they launched into those clouds, and the vehicle was struck by lightning. This is the Apollo 12 lesson learned. The Apollo 12 did a study on lightning strikes for vehicles with long plumes behind them, and they created this big database and study on the topic of triggered lightning. And that's what this rule was for, triggered lightning. It would have been nice if the launch commit criteria had the word lightning anywhere in it, but it didn't. It just says, thick clouds, don't go. The word freezing was in there, and you can see what's going on here. We've got creative people, and they will question things, and they're goal-oriented. If we'd just had a little bit more in there to help them, or someone in the room who was around to read or understand what came out of Apollo and add that to the discussion, we might have saved this accident. So, the endorsement to the accident report said that very thing. Insert the rationale next to your LCCs. And to this day, when you look at the flight rules at JSC for a shuttle, I assume for station, The flight rules, there's a flight rule, and then right under it in italics is a two or three liner that's the rationale for that rule. Why do we do that? Because of that. So that the people who are working with that rule, and of course you don't look into rationale on ascent and real high speed events, but there's a lot of times when it's good to know why the rule is there, because you got two or three other things going on and this may not really apply in your case. So you got to know why that rule is there. And this lesson really should have been applied not just to LCCs and to flight rules. It should really have applied to all our requirements.